How do you manage your group boards on Pinterest? Like, oh my gosh, pinning to them is so hard because there's all these different rules. Everybody has a different limit. I can pin 2 pins on this board, but I can only pin 5 pins on this board per day. I can only pin 1 pin on this board, but it can't be a giveaway. Oh my gosh, like how do you keep it all straight? So I'm gonna share with you how I do that with board lists in Tailwind. Let's get started. Watch to the end to see how to use this awesome tool that's gonna help you manage your group boards in Tailwind. How do you loop your pins on Pinterest using Tailwind? Well, today I'm gonna show you how. So there's a few different steps to this process, and I have a free download that you can grab, plus a blog post that details all of these steps. So check the description of this video for links to those things, and over on the blog post, you'll be able to also find that free download checklist with all the steps to loop your pins on Tailwind. And this is not using their smart loop tool that is in beta testing right now. So this is something that everyone can do. You don't need special access. All you gotta do is sign up for Tailwind. So the first step is make sure that you're signed up for Tailwind. You can sign up using the link down in the description of this video, or there are links in the blog post that I've linked here where you can go and sign up for Tailwind there. And when you sign up for Tailwind through my link, I get a little bit of a kickback from Tailwind, but you also get a free trial. So it's a win-win on both sides. Once you're signed up with Tailwind and you're ready to go, go over to your boards on Pinterest. Now, one of the challenges with managing group boards is the rules change. Every single board has different rules. Some boards don't have rules. Some boards have rules about how often you can pin. Some boards have rules about the type of content that you can pin. So what we want to do is look at every single group board and figure out which ones have limits and then what those limits are. So you can identify your group boards very easily from the list of boards on your Pinterest account by looking at the icon. Notice that on your own boards, you don't have a little circle profile picture, but on your group boards, there's a circle profile picture and it is divided up like a pie graph with other people's pictures in them. So the biggest picture is the person that owns the group board, and then the smaller pictures are the other people that are contributing to the group board. So we're gonna go check this one out, Most Pin DIY Tutorials. She has some rules here, but basically you can pin as much as you want. But she does have some rules about you can't add giveaways, Etsy, and other things like that. You want to make sure that you make a note of those rules. You can just create a little spreadsheet, put the group board name, the URL, and then the rules right in there. But this one doesn't have any limits, so I could pin to it a bunch of times if I wanted to. You don't really want to overload the board with your own pins. It's good to know that there's no limit. Now there are other boards that do have limits. Like this board says you can only pin 2 of your own pins a day. So they want you to pin your best stuff, no store links. So that means they don't want affiliate links and things like that. Make sure that they are good pins. And this board is not accepting any new people. If you're looking for new boards to join, you want to look at the guidelines in the board description, and that usually will tell you how to join the board or whether or not it's closed to any new people. So this one has a limit of 2 pins per day. Now, how am I going to keep track of that? 2 pins per day right here. This one is however many I want to do. I don't even know how many this one is. How do you keep track of this? So first, make a note of which boards have a limit of types of content. So like for Most Pin DIY, I can't do giveaways, etc. And then make a list of boards that have limits based on number. And the ones with the limits based on number are going to be the easiest for us to deal with in Tailwind. So all the boards that have a limit of 1 pin per day, all the boards with a limit of 2 pins per day, and all the boards with a limit of 4 or 5, however many pins per day there is. So I'm gonna go over here to Tailwind, and what I wanna do is make board lists. And you can see that I already have some here, and what I did is I went through the boards that have a limit of 5 pins per day, and I broke them out by topic, because I have a lot of boards that have a limit of 5, and I wanna make sure that I'm pinning to them all every day, so that I'm not missing any days. But because the different boards have different topics, I can't take like a taco recipe and pin it to every board that has a limit of 5, because some of those are DIY boards and some of them are Halloween and some of them are food, et cetera, et cetera. So you wanna make sure that you're pinning the content to boards that have similar content. So if I was pinning a DIY home decor thing, I would pin it to these two boards, and these each have a limit of 5 pins per day. So that means I can use this list to schedule 5 different pins per day to these boards. The same with my food board. I have limit 5 in this list. These are all the boards that have a limit of 5 pins per day. And then for some of them, like limit 1 per day, I only have one board with that, but I want to make sure that I have that group board in this list. And what I've done also is I made sure that all of my group boards are in lists. This way, when I'm going to pin regularly, I only pin to boards that I own and not group boards when I'm scheduling my regular Pinterest scheduling. And then I do the group board scheduling after I've already pinned to my own boards. That way I don't mistakenly pin to a group board when they have a limit or something else like that. So I have limit 1 per day. I have one in there. I have a board called limit 3 per day. These are all boards that are a list called limit 3 per day. These are all boards that have a limit of 3 per day. Here's limit 2 per day, etc. So you might notice that the content is all mixed up on here. And so to make things a little bit easier when I have a lot of boards on a list, because this one there's not very many, I broke them out. Like on the limit 5, there's a lot. So I have DIY home, food, and then I have another one for miscellaneous, which is everything that's not already on food and home. So once you've figured out the limits on the boards, you've organized them into board lists based on the number of pins you can add per day. And then if you have a lot of boards, also broken out by the topic, now you're ready to start pinning. But first you might go, oh my gosh, I can't keep this straight in my head. It's gonna be so hard. I made this spreadsheet that I can use to track my pins. And so I just put little short names for my pins. I'm using like a short code notation here so that I know which pins I've already scheduled. So for example, on the limit 1 list for June 28th, I scheduled this 3-dip recipe on that one board. And then on the limit 2 list, my first pin was the 3-dip recipe. And then my second pin, because I can pin 2 pins per day on that list, is for ground beef tacos. And then the same with the limit 3, I've got 3 pins that I'm gonna be pinning on June 28th, and these are the 3 different pins. And then again for 5, etc. Now there are some hacks when you have a post that has multiple pins, and I'm gonna show you guys how to do that too. So first, let's go ahead and pin a recipe or a blog post so that you can see how this works, and then I will show you how to do it when you have multiple pins on a post for like maximum impact. And this is gonna save you a lot of time every month. So I've got my board list already set up. I've got this Mexican 3-dip recipe post ready to go. I'm just gonna click the Tailwind icon. And from there, I'm gonna choose my 1-pin image. Now I could also pin some of these other longer images if I wanted to, but I'm just gonna stick with this one. Click to go schedule here on Tailwind. And this is just a single pin. Now, because I've already pinned that dip as many times as I could to all of the food boards that are in the limit 5 food list, I'm going to go over here to the miscellaneous list, because in that list, I know that there is a board that I could pin this to that I haven't pinned it to yet. And that's because it's for food and crafts. And so it doesn't fit only in food and it doesn't fit only in DIY. So it's in here in the miscellaneous area. So this will be my second pin for the limit 5 miscellaneous board. So I've pasted my name of the pin here so that I can keep track that yes, I've already pinned this, and I don't want to come back and pin that recipe again in the next like 30 days or so, because I don't want to oversaturate these group boards with just my own pins. So I've marked it. I'm going to pin it for June 28th to the miscellaneous list. So over here, I've got that post pulled up. I've got my pin here, and I'm going to type in limit 5 miscellaneous, and I'm going to uncheck everything that does not match with the topic. So Halloween, holiday, and crafts don't match, but these two boards I can totally pin this to. So what I'm going to do now is set the interval. Now if I was scheduling just to one board, what I would do is just schedule it so it would publish on that specific day. So it needs to publish on June 28th. But because I'm scheduling it to more than one board, now I need to use the interval settings to make sure that everything is spaced out correctly. So I'm gonna go June 28th, which is today. I'm gonna make this start a little bit later from now. And then I'm gonna look down here at the bottom to make sure that this pin is being posted only within today. So if my interval was too large, like here I put it to 10 and a half hours, it would pin something tomorrow, and that would mess up my flow for tomorrow because I'd have too many pins tomorrow going to those group boards and not enough pins today. So you just want to kind of drag this little slider bar until you can get those dates and those times within the same 24-hour period, the same single day. So here I have 628, 628 looks awesome, and I can click set interval and then schedule now. And the reason you want to use the intervals and you want to actually schedule the post as opposed to putting it in the queue is if you decide to shuffle your queue, now they're not lined up to post on the right day. It can put too many pins on those group boards in one day and not enough on another day, and then you're in trouble with the group board admin. So that's how you do it if you have one pin on the post. Now, what about the blog posts where you have multiple pin images? How do you pin those? Well, this one has a few different pin images associated with it, but it also has some long images that could be pinned additionally. So I'm gonna go ahead and click the Tailwind button and pull the long pin images. So here I have two images from this post. You can also do this with four images, etc. And you can upload your images to Pinterest and pin that way as well. Okay, so now that I have my two different pin images here, what I want to do is instead of typing the board list into each pin, I'm going to add all of these to the board list. So I'm going to go to limit one per day, limit two per day, limit three, limit five, home, and then limit five, miscellaneous. It's not a recipe, so I can't put it on the recipe one. But then I need to go through, now that these have all been dumped in here, and cherry pick the ideas that actually fit, or the boards that actually fit with this content. So it's not Halloween. It is holiday. It's a craft and recipe, home decor, home improvement, red, white, and blue. It's not a food blog. It's not graphic design. It's not mason jar. It's not a recipe. But any of these other ones, it totally fits with. And what that does is it dumps these boards here into the list, basically into the queue for each of these pins. And what I want to do is I want to schedule them on the interval just like I did before, but now I need to make sure that I'm pinning them at the right time. Now over here in the spreadsheet, I want to make sure that I'm pinning this on the correct day. So I'm going to put it on June 29th on the limit one day, on June 29th limit two, June 29th limit three list. I'm not doing any food, but it's DIY and it is miscellaneous. So I'm going to make sure that everything's going out on June 29th. Now you might say, oh my gosh, that's a lot. Like, we don't want them all to go out on that one day because it's just going to make your feed crazy. But because I'm pinning 50 times a day, it's not going to make my feed look that crazy and I'm spreading the pins out. But if you were pinning only maybe 20 times a day, five pins of the same thing in a day is a lot. It's going to overload your feed. So you might want to do something like make the first board, do your limit one list by itself so that that starts today, and then the limit two list by itself so that starts tomorrow, etc. And the beauty of using the spreadsheet is you can space everything out like this if you want to really easily. Now I write all the text in black, and then once I've scheduled it, I make it green. So I'm going to go back over here to where I was scheduling it. And from here, I'm going to set my interval. So this is the first pin. It's going to start on the 29th. I'm going to start it in the morning. And I need to check my dates to make sure that everything stays within the 29th. And right now it's not. So I'm going to pull this over just a tad. So it's pinning every 1 hour. That works. Let's try 1.5. 1.5 does not work. So we need to pin it every 1 hour. So then I'm going to go ahead and click set interval and schedule now. Now what about the second pin? I'll do the same thing with that on June 30th and schedule it. And because I'm scheduling all of these right now, I can go ahead and make them the green color so that I know that they're done. So this one would start on June 30th. So I'm going to go ahead and use interval. I'm going to set my date to June 30th and make sure that it's all pinning within June 30th, which it is. Set interval, schedule now. And you can see how quickly you can fill up your schedule and fill up your queue and schedule all of this super duper fast. Let me know if you guys have any questions on this. It's a little bit tricky, but it will help you with making sure that you don't go over on your board limits. Now, do you like that spreadsheet? You can get it for yourself. Click the link down in the description to find out how to get your own copy of our board manager spreadsheet. Do you got any blogger friends that you think would benefit from this video? Maybe they were using another tool and they can't figure out how to loop or do campaigns with their pins on group boards. Share this video with them, tag them down in the comments so that they see it, or click that share button, copy the link, and share it with your friends. I would really appreciate it. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.